Hello dear students, welcome to our chemistry class. I am your chemistry lecturer. My name is Supriya Shegunshi. In our today's class, I will be going to discuss some basic points involved in the chemistry. Dear students, what is meant by chemistry? Because chemistry it is having a wide range of definitions. Because some of say that chemistry it is the study of chemicals. Some of say that chemistry it is the study of reactions. Okay, but chemistry means here I will provide one definition according to me. Chemistry means that is the it is a mixture of chemicals plus history. Is it right? It is a mixture of chemicals plus history. Okay. To know the chemicals history, and you have to discover or you have to invent the new things. That is known as a chemistry. ನಿಮಗೆ ಏನಾದರೂ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿತ್ತಂತಂದರೆ ಅದೇ ವೇ ಒಳಗೆ ಏನಂತಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನು ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಏನಾದರೂ ಹೊಸ ವಿಷಯಗಳನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿಯೋತಿದ್ದು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೇನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನಾವು ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಡೀಲ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಆಫ್ ಕಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ as well as properties as well as interaction of matter is known as a chemistry. Already you know about this one. Okay dear student, chemistry it is a branch of science. It deals with the composition, properties as well as interaction of matter. It is collectively known as a chemistry. Here according to your section, that is a BSc section, here your paper it is containing the totally 150 marks. That is a mass distribution. Here totally your paper containing 150 marks. Out of 150, 80 marks for theory, another one 20 marks for IA, that is the internal assessment, another one for that is the 50 marks for your practical examination purpose or your practical purpose. Totally there are the 150 marks for each paper. Okay, so now in our today's class here I will discuss some basic concept or some basic importance chemistry in our day to day life, as well as what are the careers involved in the chemistry section. Okay, after your BSc. So here chemistry it stands for, C stands for community, H stands for health, E stands for environment, M stands for medicine, I stands for industry, S stands for science, T stands for teaching, R stands for research, Y stands for you. Okay, it is collectively known as a chemistry. Here in our day to day life, chemistry it plays a very important role. Chemistry it plays a very important role. That is, it is the gift of chemistry. Okay, it is a gift of chemistry. In our daily life, we have to use the soaps as well as hair oils, and then toothpaste, cosmetics, as well as sanitizer or hand wash, food we eat, clothes we wear, etc. It is totally dependent upon that is the chemistry. Means chemistry it is the king of science. Is it right? Okay, so now here branches of chemistry. Branches of chemistry means already you know only three sections, that is a physical, organic as well as inorganic. But here according to your BSc section, here some again different types of chemistry branches will study here. First one is a physical chemistry, organic chemistry is there, inorganic chemistry, analytical chemistry, spectroscopy and industrial chemistry. Let me see here what is meant by organic chemistry. What you study in the organic chemistry, that is the study of molecules of life. Study of molecules of life, that is the organic compounds. It is known as the organic chemistry. Next one is a analytical chemistry. It is a new idea for you. What is the analytical chemistry means? Identification of material in a mixture. Okay, identification of materials in a mixture, it is dependent upon the qualitative analysis or quantitative analysis. Here it is the invention procedure for the analysis. Here this is about the analytical chemistry. Next one is a physical chemistry. What is meant by physical chemistry? Physical chemistry means it is a study of fundamental physical principles and govern the way atoms, molecules and other chemical system behavior. In this one we will study about the thermodynamics, chemical kinetics, chemical reactions, polymers, etc. We have to study in this chemical, physical chemistry section. Okay. So now next one is the inorganic chemistry. What is meant by inorganic chemistry? Just it is the reversible form of the organic chemistry. What is that one? Here the study of those areas that do not deal with the carbon, that is the inorganic compound, it is the inorganic chemistry. And the next one is the industrial chemistry. Industrial chemistry means it is deals with the study of industrial related chemistry. Okay. So now it is known as a industrial chemistry. So now next one, it is a very important point is the what are the careers in chemistry. It is a very interesting and then it is very important to us. Okay. What are the careers in chemistry? See here, what can I do with my degree after I graduate in BSc? The question will arise in your mind. Okay. Here, what can I do with my degree after I graduate in BSc? Here, don't worry about the careers in chemistry because it is having a lot of opportunities in several types of chemistry, okay, industries. Here, chemistry is often referred to as the central sciences because chemistry plays a very vital role in nearly every other scientific field. Here, this presentation outlined some of the common areas where chemists work. Okay, here, see this one, that is a government sectors, KPSC, UPSC, SSC, forest area, banking sector, air force, army, navy, as well as academics. Okay, and then here next one is one main thing, that is industries right there. Okay, so see here, chemistry careers in brief, it is having a wide range of opportunities. Okay, these are the different sectors involved in the chemistry. What is that one? First one is the agricultural chemistry. Next one is the analytical chemistry. You have best opportunity in analytical chemistry. Next one, biochemistry, biotechnology, catalysis, chemical education, chemical engineering, chemical information, chemical sales, chemical technology, collision surfaces, consulting, consumer products, environmental, foods and flavors, forensic chemistry, geochemistry, waste management, inorganic chemistry, material science, medicinal chemistry, organic chemistry, oil and petroleum, physical chemistry, polymer chemistry, pulp and paper, R&D management, science writing, textile chemistry, water chemistry, etc. Is it right? Chemistry, it is a king of science. Are you agree? Okay. ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಇಷ್ಟೊಂದೆಲ್ಲ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಅಪಾರ್ಚುನಿಟೀಸ್ ಏನದಾವ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಅದಾವೆ. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನೀವೇನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯನ್ನು ಸೋ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಕೇಟೆಡ್, ಹೌದಾ? ಇದು ಕಷ್ಟ ಏನಲ್ಲ. ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೋ ಸಿಂಪಲ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಏನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಹಿಂಟ್ಸನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮಗೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಅ ಸೋ ಈಸಿ. ಸಿ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಗರೀಸ್, ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಗರೀಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದು ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಆಯಿತು. ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಇನ್ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್, ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫೈನ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್, ಪೆಟ್ರೋಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್, ಪೆಸ್ಟಿಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಗ್ರೋಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್, ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸರ್ಸ್, ಡೈಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪಿಗ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಪೇಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾರ್ನಿಷಸ್, ಸೋಪ್ಸ್, ಪರ್ಫ್ಯೂಮ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಸ್ಯೂಟಿಕಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್. ಇಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಕೂಡ ನೀವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾಗಿತ್ತಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಥರೋಲಿ ಗುಡ್ ನಾಲೆಜನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿದ್ರೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಜಾಬನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಸಿ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಕೆರಿಯರ್ಸ್, ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಕೆರಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಲ್ಯಾಬ್ಸ್ US ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್. It offered national research labs employed for a BSc as well as MSc and PhD scientists who carry out research on a wide variety of topics. National labs often on environmental, that is a cross between industrial and academic research. Dear students, neve en madabodu antandre after BSc MSc na madabodu, okay, in the different branches of chemistry. Athwa neevu competitive examination ku kuda hogabodu, but related to chemistry here I am talking about only chemistry. Okay, you are having a variety of opportunities. See here the Next one is a federal, state and local governments offer a variety of opportunities for students with chemistry degrees. Here next one is that is the regulatory agencies, departments such as EPA, FBI, FDA, ATF, etc. employ chemistry who carry research and perform analytical services in support of the regulatory role of these agencies. Okay. So now here top Indian pharmaceutical companies. What are the top Indian pharmaceutical companies in our India? Here Sun Pharm and Dr. Reddy's Lab is the Kifla, and then GSK is there, Strides is there, Lufin is there, Arbindo is there, Ocard is there, Zydas Cadila is there, Natco is there, Orchid is there, IPCA is there, Biocon is there, Torrent, Shasun, Alembic, etc. Niveen Madrantandra chemistry na very interesting age study madre. ಅವಾಗೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ಟಾಪ್ ಕಂಪ್ನೀಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಜಾಬ್ ಅನ್ನ ಪಡೆಯಬಹುದು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಗೋಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ. ಇವತ್ತಿನ ದಿನದೊಳಗೆ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಅವಕಾಶವನ್ನು ಒದಗಿಸಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟರು ಕೂಡ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಏನದಾವ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಸ್ ಅದಾವ. ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್? ಹಿಯರ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಸ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಡಿಗ್ರೇಡೇಷನ್, ಚಾಲೆಂಜಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಡಿಗ್ರೇಡೇಷನ್, alternatives to environmentally hazardous refrigerators like chlorofluorocarbons, that is commonly known as a CFCs, it is responsible for ozone depletion, has been successfully developed. Here main challenges in the chemistry field, that is the environmental problems. Next one, management of greenhouse gases. What are the greenhouse gases? That is the methane, carbon dioxide, etc. Here the understanding biochemical process, use of enzymes for large scale production of chemicals, these are the main challenges in the chemistry field is there. Okay, so now today I discussed in this session, that is my basic chemistry. Okay, so now in the next video session I will be start syllabus directly, just you will be wait for that one.